Hello, my name is Luis Estrada, and I'm a software developer.
In this video, I'll show you how to design an HTML email. Now that you've created your own magazine or store online and added online payments to it, it is time you keep in touch with your clients. You could write them an HTML email as verification of the purchased order, as a welcome message to your online magazine, or as a newsletter to keep users informed of new products, services, or content added to your website. An HTML email could also be used to try to get your customers back after they have bought products on your website or after their membership account for your website has expired. You could use HTML to create a message that looks interesting, including images and links, and make your email exciting. You can even set up templates to send your email in a special format depending upon what you want to write. Here are some tips that will help you create a great HTML email. You should think of the email message as an extension of your website. Upload the images on your website and then link to them in your email using absolute URLs. Be sure to use absolute paths for both images and links. You need to use absolute paths in an HTML email to ensure that the images display and the links work. An email is not a web page. When your users arrive to your website, you have the whole browser window in which to display your message. Email is different. An email inbox is a very noisy place with tons of messages, folders, calendars, and other distractions. Your subscribers may only read the subject line or perhaps see your email through a small preview pane. You need to design your email accordingly and make the best use of the screen space and time the readers give you. Get to the point quickly. Start with the most valuable information. Your readers should be able to glance at the top of the email and know immediately what it's about. Consider starting with a table of contents or a short summary that will entice them to read the full email. This is especially useful if you send monthly newsletters. Another very important activity before sending your email is testing. Your clients could use different email providers. Some could use email client applications to download their emails to their computers like Outlook or Thunderbird. Others might prefer to check their email online using a service like Hotmail, Gmail, or Yahoo. You should always test sending your HTML emails to at least one account in each of these email readers. That way you could verify that the email looks good in each one. Another action that you can take is to test the emails on different browsers. There are at least 4 or 5 major web browsers that you should do testing on. There are cases when a user sees the same HTML email on different browsers and the page looks quite different. For example, if you see an HTML email using your Gmail account in both Firefox 3 and Internet Explorer 7, the result could be quite different. I realize that we are talking about a lot of testing, but I believe that it is better to invest time on this than losing potential customers that cannot read your email correctly.
I'm Luis Estrada, and I've just showed you how to make money with your websites.